If you are a service-based business, you are engaged with clients on a regular basis and very likely need a nice, clean way to share project information with your clients. Well, in this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you exactly how to build a client portal using one of my favorite no-code tools, Softr. So if learning about this is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tool suite, and Softr is one of our favorite no-code tools that we're going to be talking about in this video. We are also going to be using Airtable as a backend, but do note that you don't have to use Airtable. You could also be building your backend with Google Sheets, Smart Suite, etc. Before we hop into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to take advantage of a free trial that Softr has made available to our viewers. Simply follow the steps as I am demonstrating on my screen here, and you can get one free month with Softr on their high tier and get immediate access to over $100 in savings. So in order to take advantage of that, simply enter the promo code that you see on your screen. We will drop that below this video wherever you found it. Without further ado, though, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and get started. Now, the first thing you might ask yourself is, why would I want a client portal template? And my answer to that is, why wouldn't you? If you are a service-based business, interacting with your customers and having a consolidated place to share all of your information is vital. It is mission critical for you to perform your service appropriately. And so a client portal is going to help you stay organized, interact with your customers, and of course, make sure that your customers know what's expected of them, make sure that your team knows what's next and what's expected of them. There are so many different moving parts. Now, once you're ready to install this template, simply go to the link that I've shared with this video for the template and you'll click on Use Template. Now, this of course supposes that you're already logged into Softr, so if you're not, you'll have to do that first. And notice that you have two different database selection options here. You can store your information, as I said, in either Airtable or Google Sheets. Now, it is important to know that other backends are supported, but they're not necessarily integrated with this template. So if you were to use a different backend, you'd have to build this part from scratch. In our case, though, I don't want to waste time building the data structure. Let's just get it going. So first we'll say use template, and we'll select our data source. Now, if we don't already have a data source connected, we can simply go through the motions here and sync up with whatever data source we're going to use to store our information. In our case, this is going to be Airtable. So let's go ahead and build this connection, give it access to all of our data in Airtable, or you can select to only share certain things. And then we're going to copy this database. The backend structure is what we're copying and installing inside of our Airtable setup. Choose the workspace that you want to share this to and add this database. And once you've done so, you'll see that you're now in your data source, in this case, Airtable, and I'm inside of my new database that was just copied called Client Portal by Softr. Now, high level, we can look at our different data sets. We have users. These are the people who can log into our app. We have companies. We have files, projects, tasks, invoices, milestones, project updates, and comments. Now in Airtable, we would not use a table for comments, but in the case of using Softr, we will use comments as its own set of data, and it's going to connect to the tasks and also tag the commenter. This might seem a little confusing, but this will make sense when we get to the actual application itself. So now that we have the database set up, let's flip back into Softr, and we're going to now copy the application into our solutions. So this, what you see being created right now, is the actual final output of this application. So this is the backend builder inside of Softr, where I can come in and make changes. I can move blocks around. I can reorganize things. I can hide different elements. But ultimately, what we're doing is building a web application, but we've done it with just a few clicks because it all came from a template. Now we can go to pages here and see the different pages that we have. Each one of these represents a unique page inside of our application that was simply and easily copied over. Now, We also want to make sure that all of this is synced properly to our Airtable backend. And so we can go to one of these different data sources and click on the block itself. And you'll see over here that we already have a data source established. And this will be true for all of the different components inside of our new application. So for us, it's synced to my Airtable. It's going to that database that we just copied, and this is pulling information in from the project in Airtable. Now, I get asked this question a lot. People are always wondering, does this mean that people can see everything? And no, it does not. We have conditional filters set up here that only make data visible from our projects under certain conditions. So if the project name is meeting certain criteria, or if there's an admin access, or if we have a project name with a specific client name. These are different rules that have already been set up, making it so that only certain people can access the data. And bear in mind that with Softr, we can give granular permission to allow people to update, edit, add new records, delete records, etc. So all of the information lives in Airtable, but it's going to be visible nicely and easily from our Softr app. So before moving on, I just want to highlight that this is all entirely customizable. You can create a unique look and flow to your web application and add or remove blocks as needed. But for us, we're going to go with what we have here, and we're just going to take this out for a spin. We'll publish our app. Now I'm going to head on over to my users table, and here you're going to see all the different examples of different folks that we have in our database. Now, this is one-to-one matching with the information inside of Airtable. So if we go to our users, you're going to see that we've got these different users with different roles. And that's exactly what we're seeing here, the different usernames and emails, and they're assigned to different groups based on their roles. The groups are all driven by the groups here, and we can edit these groups, but we have admin, clients, employees, and freelancers. Important to note that each one of these user groups will have a completely different experience inside of the application. We can customize what each user group can see and edit and update and delete, etc. So let's take this out for a spin as a client. You want to know at the end of the day, what's my client's user experience going to look like? Well, here's a magic link for Lucy Smith, an example client inside of our application. Let's copy this link. Open up in a new tab and paste that link in. This is taking us now to Lucy's experience as a client. So when Lucy logs in, here's what she sees. It's going to say portal up here on the side. This is, of course, customizable, and you can replace this with your own branding, favicon, logo, etc. Lucy, as a client, has access to her dashboard, tasks, projects, company profile, invoices, and resources. So here we can look at on her dashboard, outstanding tasks. So here we have the past research results. Lucy can come in and update the status here with just a simple click, update this to say, this is in progress, and save those changes. Now this data is actually going to be immediately updated on the back end. So if we go to our data source in Airtable and we look at our tasks, and if we scroll down to the bottom, we're going to see that task right here, provide past research results. And of course, that status is now in progress. As Lucy makes changes to this and moves it through the process, she can move it to done, for example, and save those changes. This is now gone, all taken care of. So Lucy has paid all her invoices. She's completed all her tasks, and that data is immediately updated on the back end in Airtable. Now, she can come in here to my tasks and click through, take a look at different tasks, and now you can see that this one is in the done category here. If new tasks are assigned to Lucy and only assigned to Lucy, they will show up here. Note that in our application, we have dozens of tasks. Only this one is assigned to Lucy. This is the only one that shows up in her instance of the application. Also, Lucy can come over to company profile and update information about her company. So here you can see the information that is on file for the company that Lucy is logged in representing. In this case, Ace Poly. You can see their web address. You can see a list of contacts. New contacts could even be added here and immediately brought into the database as representatives of this organization. We also have invoices. These were also visible on the dashboard, but here we could look in at the invoice status and look at those that have been paid or payments are sent for or unpaid, etc. All of this is completely filterable and we can look at the status over time. And then of course, resources. Here are some frequently asked questions. We could bring up a video as you see here and just be able to watch whatever happened in the most recent webinar. All of Lucy's questions can be answered right here, but of course, most importantly, when she gets stuck, if she gets stuck, a simple click to go down to schedule a meeting with her account manager. A really amazing tool that we've created in just a few clicks. And remember, this is only one of four different user groups, every user group having its own unique experience when they access the application. As a closing thought, if you found this interesting, I want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is one of those core components of no-code solutions. It's going to help you save and reclaim so much of your time with a little bit of automation magic in no-code. You can learn the fundamentals at our free training, gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I hope you got a ton of value from this video and implement this template. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to swing by our website and reach out. And in the meantime, keep on building.